This is Comic Book Shoes, scene 3, take 1. I thought you were gonna clap. Oh, there we go, that's official.
Miss Jess?
Yes?
I'm super excited. I would buy something like this. Like, I have Star Wars shoes. These comic book shoes are the best.
And today, we're gonna show you how to make them. It's very easy. It is kind of time consuming, though. I would say, like, the biggest thing about this craft is patience, because you have to let the layers dry in between.
Can I read this first?
No, we gotta cut that baby up today. $3.99, so you could buy yourself 2 copies. And then have one to read and one to
And the shoes weren't very expensive either.
No, I just got them at Old Navy. More of like a Vans slip-on look so that we could cover the whole shoe.
I just love this technique in general. It doesn't have to be comic books. You could really like kind of make your own shoe out of whatever. Like a 17 magazine shoe.
Totally.
I don't know who would want to do that.
You want the thinnest paper possible to make these shoes. We're using comic book pages today, and even that's a little thick. Mm. But the thinner the paper, the better the shoe is gonna come out.
You can take the pages you want, photocopy them onto a thinner piece of paper,
yeah,
right?
If
and
you
then
want,
use
yeah.
that.
So first step is to tape off your shoes with painter's tape. You wanna cover the places that you don't want glue or pictures on. Say if you're gonna take time on any step, this is the step you wanna take the most time on, because it makes peeling the tape off at the end so much easier if you've taken the time to be detailed with it.
This is really therapeutic because I'm usually not a patient person, so crafts often teach me to like take a minute, have an intention versus just like, I'm gonna tape it and then yeah. glue it and then I'm done.
I also think this would be a really fun craft to do with kids who are a little bit older. You know, 7, 8.
Ooh, the curvy parts are the hardest.
The most important part is you wanna avoid the tape getting on the area where you're actually gonna Mod Podge.
Did you ever read comic books?
I did not, no.
Well, I was a big nerd, so.
I mean, I was pretty nerdy.
Yeah.
I was like into my Harry Potter books.
Oh, yes. But you like the movies, right, Jess?
I love the Avengers movies. No spoilers, loved the ending.
It was satisfying, sad.
Who's your favorite?
I really like Captain America in the movies. Mm-hmm. I think Captain America is probably my favorite MCU character.
Solid decision.
Hopeful, and then like kind of a little jaded, and then
yeah.
like, you know, but always still Captain America at the core, so.
Totally.
I kind of liked his arc throughout the whole series. But from the comic books, my favorite comic book character is Storm.
Oh, really?
X-Men was my favorite comic book, and I just loved Storm.
On
Halle Berry?
No. Like I did see her actually.
I was about to say.
Yeah, I did see her one time. She's hot. Okay, while you're finishing up your shoe, I'm gonna start picking out which images I want. Oh, when you're picking your images, I started with what I want on the top of my shoes first.
Can I call dibs on something?
Yeah.
Full page image of the Infinity Gauntlet. I want to use
this one.
Like, no. Oh, this one.
Ooh.
Yes. Those are gonna make the brightest, coolest shoes. Now we should do a safety warning. If you are doing this with kids, maybe give them the safe scissors.
The safe scissors.
Safe scissors, not the blade. Can you inspect my shoes? See how they I did.
See, it's like this. How it's like coming up on the side there.
Yeah.
You can trim it up, or you just push it down with your nails.
Okay, just tuck it in there.
Oh no,
I cut into my Spider-Man.
Oh no! You don't have to have an X-Acto knife for this craft. You can do it with just scissors, but it comes in handy. I think we should find like pow or bam.
Oh, like the words.
Yeah, the words. Yeah. And it just adds some character to the shoes.
Okay, so we're doing an Infinity Gauntlet shoes on the, what is this, the toe? The front?
Yeah.
And then we'll do some little character squares around the ankle and the side.
So what I did is I did like my base layer of paper mache, and then I cut out some of the characters and put them on the top too. The layering kind of makes the effect, I think.
I got a hard question for you.
Uh-oh, oh no.
If you had the Infinity Gauntlet, Jess, for one snap, what would you use it for?
Something profound, like have
world
everyone
peace.
Be kind to one another. Yes, but like, I don't know if the Infinity Stone can even do that. Oh. Even then, it takes away your free will, right?
There you go.
The whole point is that you have to be kind because you wanna be, not because some stone makes you be kind.
All right, then what superpower would you have?
I want to fly. I've always wanted to
fly. The powers that I've always loved in like comic books and stuff are the psychic characters.
Oh yeah.
Infinity shoes.
Okay, I'm gonna start.
Okay.
Mod Podging. So as you start putting your images on, the idea is to kind of just soak the paper. You want to get it as covered as possible and then just keep covering until that paper is soggy so that it kind of forms to the shoe.
You want to wet it. Like,
yes.
Yeah, get it soggy.
So I put a layer on the shoe, I put a layer of Mod Podge on the back of this image, and then I stuck it on there and put a ton more on top.
Get the big bottle.
Yeah, just get the big bottle.
Get the big bottle.
And don't be shy. Don't be afraid that it looks white when you're covering it. When it dries, it'll be clear. I kind of run my finger, if you can see, I run my finger along the image where I need to cut it. And when it gets wet, it'll start to kind of indent that way. And then I can take it off and cut it how I need to cut it.
These look so awesome. I love that we featured the like infinity gauntlet. Like yours has the big glove in the front. Mine has like a whole glove right here. So when these dry, these are gonna look so cool.
As you're going, the edging at the top here will start to dry. Sometimes it'll kind of dry and start to fold back into a straight line. And you can just take the edge of your paintbrush here and run it along the edge to keep those pieces formed to the shoe.
I feel like back a few years ago, like some kids would get made fun of for like reading comic books and stuff. And then
back
now,
in our day.
Now adults are gonna go see Pokemon movies and everybody.
I wanna see the Pokemon movie.
I remember when everything used to be like nerdy and people would get teased for doing stuff. And I'm like, yeah, now look who's laughing.
I saved my Iron Man for the end and he's gonna go right across the shoe. So he's right front and center next to my Infinity Gauntlet.
Good. I think it's more fun if you have like a theme and just like we were saying earlier, some purpose, some intention behind what you're doing.
Definite conversation starters.
That's what's so great about these is if you wear them, people are gonna be like, where'd you get those?
Yeah.
Guess what? They're custom. That's all you have to say.
Definitely gonna.
They're custom.
They're custom.
All right, so we're wrapping up here. Jess, what's next?
So I let them dry for, I would say a couple of hours, I let them dry, and then I did another coat of Mod Podge on the top. Not a really sopping layer again, just another little go around with the Mod Podge to make sure all my corners were down and everything was how I wanted it. I let them dry overnight.
Shazam! Oh, these are Marvel shoes, not DC shoes, so I can't say Shazam.
Yeah, I was gonna say, should we show off our completed?
Yeah, I really like the sides with the tiles of characters.
Yeah.
That really worked out. Oh, you have a Wolverine on yours.
Decided to do a Captain America on the side here.
Got my Spider-Man, my Captain America there.
Iron Man, obviously, front and center. You can't really see it, but when it dries, the Infinity Gauntlet's gonna be right there.
Ooh, yeah. I did the big Infinity Gauntlet right here.
Oh yeah, so yours is huge. Mm-hmm. That's perfect.
Mm-hmm. These shoes are looking so good.
They look so good. We let them dry for about 3 hours, I would say.
Yeah, a little lunch and drink break.
It is Friday. And now we are just putting another thin layer of Mod Podge over the top of the comic book strips. And that'll just help to seal it all together.
So just making sure it's just like even thin layer, all the bubbles are pressed out.
Every time I've done this, I've had a few little creases, and when they dry and they're done, you can't even really tell. So don't stress about the creases.
But I like how these turned out. I mean, they're colorful, really vibrant. They're really bright, really vibrant. We used a lot of those Infinity Stone colors,
I love the Infinity Gauntlet.
Send us your orders. Only $155 per shoe.
Oh, okay. Well, no, we should charge more.
Okay, $300 like per shoe. Thin layer on top.
Yes.
Let these dry again, maybe another couple hours
or overnight,
you said?
I would let them dry overnight if you have the time. The last thing you want is like wet Mod Podge on your shoes as you try to wear them.
These are a special gift or a special project for yourself, so, you know, give it some time.
The next morning, then what you're gonna do is grab some of this. I'm using DuraClear Gloss Varnish. I got this at Michael's in the glue section. This is what's gonna help them resist the wear and tear as you wear them. Just put a thin layer on your shoes. Let them dry again overnight after you put a coat of this on. Once you put on your gloss varnish here, you have to take your tape off. The X-Acto knife helped so much to take the tape off. you'll see there's just a little overlap between the tape and the glue. So as you're peeling the tape off, it might try to pull up the image as well.
Yeah.
If you don't have an X-Acto knife, I would recommend using your finger and pinching on the edge and then pulling the tape as you go. So pinch a little and pull. And that way it'll keep your images flat so your images don't rip off.
I'm gonna make like seven different pairs of shoes.
I know, I really wanna
Harry
make a
Potter
pair
shoes.
Too.
Get your old Lisa Frank stuff out.
Oh, Lisa Frank shoes! You just made my day. Lisa Frank, here I come. Make your own comic book, pop culture shoes and share them with us on Instagram. Okay. Tag Home of the Holidays. We wanna see what you guys come up with too.
Yeah, it'd be fun to see what people come up with. Great idea, fun craft, glad to do it with you.
Cheers.